In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to install a new interior door handle by Weiser's. The process for updating your interior door handles is very simple. I'm going to show you step by step what you'll need to do. To begin, you'll want to locate the two set screws. Generally, they'll be located here and here, or sometimes on the top and the bottom. Most of the time, these two screws will be located on the inside of the room or the inside of the closet. For this door handle, those two screws are located here on the left and then also on the right. You'll need a star screwdriver or a Phillips to be able to remove these two screws. Now that we've located the two screws, we're going to remove them. For this specific handle, the screws will only come about halfway, and you'll have to separate the handle to be able to remove the screws the rest of the way. Now that you have the screws removed, you can separate the handle. This is what the interior of the handle looks like. This half moon shape slides in through the latch here. We're now ready to remove the latch. Again, it's held in by two screws here. You can now pull the latch out of the door, and this is what the latch looks like. Now that you've got the doorknob and the latch removed, we're going to remove the strike plate on the door jamb. The strike plate here on the door jamb is also held in by two screws. Now you can remove it. Now that we've got everything removed, we're ready to install the new handle. This handle is indicated as a passage. This means that it does not have a lock built into the handle. This style of handle is good for closets, pantries, and bedrooms that don't require a lock. Inside the packaging, we're going to have the front and rear of the handle. It looks very similar to the previous style we just removed. You'll have the package containing the hardware we're going to need and the latch. Inside the hardware kit, you're going to have an Allen key, a supporting ring, the screws you'll need, and a set of instructions if you need them. We're going to start by mounting the new strike plate back into the jamb. Now that the strike plate's installed, we're ready to reinstall the new latch. A few things to keep in mind is the curvature here on the latch. This will go in whatever direction pushes against the strike plate. Something else on the latch here, you'll see there's two little pins on each side. If you pull down and move forward, it'll actually extend the length of the latch. This will be used if your door hole is drilled farther back into the door. You'll need to reposition into the longer setting to allow the handle to still connect itself. This door, we're going to leave in the standard position because it fits in and it runs to the rear of the door here. Now that we have the latch in position, we're going to re-secure it again with the two smaller screws. Now that we're ready to reinstall the actual latch, you'll want to determine which is the inside and what's the outside. Again, when you look, the two mounting screws will go to the inside of the door. That means this is the front portion. You're going to look for the half moon shape. which will slide in here, and the two posts will mount through, just like that. You're now ready to secure the rear portion of the handle here. So when you go and mount the handle, you'll see that you can access the one screw, but the second one, the handle's in the way. If you wanted, you could pull down like this and work around it, but the kit does come with a long Allen key. So what you'll do is the small little set screw here, you're going to back it out a few turns, and the handle will separate. You can now mount just the plate and then reattach the handle after. Now that you're ready to reattach the two screws again, I like to start them by hand to make sure they're threading in correctly. And then I'll tighten them down. I like to apply pressure on the front and the rear of the handle to keep it aligned. Be careful not to over tighten the screws. You're now ready to reattach the handle again. And with the Allen key, you'll apply pressure to the handle here. And you can re-tighten down the set screw. The handle should have no play now. And the handle's good to go. This has been a quick and easy tutorial on how to install a new Weiser's interior door handle. If you found this video useful or you enjoyed this content, like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks for watching.